According to the Minister of Justice and Constitutional Affairs, Norbert Mao, conflicts in neighboring Kenya affect Uganda in one way or another. He says it's prudent for President Museveni to engage the Kenyan leadership to harmonize government and the opposition. Yesterday, Kenya security organs were involved in running battles with protesters on the streets who are protesting the surging cost of goods and the high cost of living.
Everything is raised up. Unga mepanda bei, mafuta gari mepanda bei, maisha wananchi mepanda bei. Zile vitu zote Ruto alikuwa anatuambia tukimtafutia kura ama tukimpigia kura. It was totally lie.
The protests were called by Kenya's opposition leader Raila Odinga.
Fortunately, the president of Kenya holds the president of Uganda in very high regard. So I would call upon the president of Uganda to become a mediator. He knows both leaders. And he can call upon other leaders also to help.
Uganda is a landlocked country and largely depends on its eastern neighborhood for imports and exports through the port of Mombasa. Kenya being Uganda's main supply route for essential goods, including fuel, any chaos in Kenya could badly affect Uganda's businesses. Relatedly, Mao told off Ugandans to stop discouraging opposition from meeting and engaging President Museveni.
Here in Uganda, if tomorrow the leader of NUP says he wants to talk to President Museveni, it is you, the Ugandans, who will discourage him. You'll say they are going to bribe him. He's going to receive money. You have reduced our politics to such a low level. As a result, you have trapped our leaders.
Mao also disclosed plans to table before cabinet proposals for the establishment of the Constitutional Review Commission.
We have just done a few edits and we are going to take the document to cabinet. What we take to cabinet are not proposals for constitutional reform. It is a proposal to establish a constitutional review commission. There are many ideas that Ugandans have been giving. Those in opposition, the public, people who have written articles. We are willing to promote a culture of deliberation.
Mao also threatened to expose members of parliament who have continued to criticize him, yet they are double-sided. Report compiled by Jaliat Namoya for the news.